Hey everyone, welcome to this week's Azure Infrastructure Update. It's the 6th of January 2023, so Happy New Year. I hope everyone had a great holidays. As I did talk about at the end of last year, although I normally recorded the updates on a Friday, I didn't release them to Sunday. Well, as best I can, I'm just going to start releasing them on Sundays straight after I record it. As always, I do have the chapters. Not many updates this week, but there are a few updates. So I have the chapters in the description. You can jump to the one you might care about the most. And on the 2nd of January, actually rolled over and hit 175,000 subscribers. So that was really cool. Nice milestone. So thank you for the support. I said to my kids, hey, let's go celebrate. Let's go and get the best burger in the world. And to them, that was McDonald's, which don't get me wrong, I enjoy a little two cheeseburgers. Wouldn't necessarily say it's the best in the world, but that's what it was. New videos this week. I released, I think it was part 4 of the V2 of the Azure Masterclass. I've been releasing these over the break. So resiliency, looking at all of the things I can think about making my service more resilient, more available. And then I discovered AutoHotkey recently. People have known about it for many, many years, but it's a really nice tool that lets me do almost anything in my Windows environment using any configurable set of keystrokes I define. So I'm starting to play around with that. On to what's actually new. So on the database side, Azure Cosmos DB V2 connector for Power BI. So for Power BI, I have this new connector that lets me bring in data from Cosmos DB. I can do an import. If it's of a size that I can import, I can store within my Power BI memory, for example, or I can actually use direct query where I just query it in place in Cosmos DB. That's gonna be really good for real-time type querying. And I can apply both filtering, I can apply aggregations to reduce the actual amount of data I have to bring in. PostgreSQL Flexible now has customer managed key in GA. So remember, the flexible SKUs are the newer versions, they're VM-based. I can stop, start the VMs, I can use burstable SKUs, I can have optional high availability, I can tweak all of the settings. So now with this flexible version of PostgreSQL, I can have that key encryption key in my key vault, so I have complete control of it, and then that's actually used to then decrypt the data encryption keys that encrypt the various blocks partitions on disk. So I can have complete control of the rotation of that key. Azure Data Explorer now has Log4j ingestion. So for my Java applications, Log4j is a very popular framework to be used. It says this new Log4j 2 sync available in Azure Data Explorer. Azure Data Explorer, remember, gives me this huge set of ingestion. It's got very powerful querying of the data using the Kusto query language. That is now GA. Onto the miscellaneous. So Azure Backup for SAP HANA has a number of updates. So if we go and jump over and look at this, so we can see there's now, firstly, well, this is a backup in certified solutions. That just means, hey, it's using the SAP HANA native APIs for the backup. It has long-term retention now for those ad hoc backups. So on-demand backups I take, I can configure retention outside of the regular policies that may be applied. I can restore as files, give me more control about, well, then what I want to do with that data, and just seamless integration with a lot of the other native tools. So some pretty cool updates there. Azure Monitor, ITSM, IT Service Management, now has support for the ServiceNow Tokyo instance. So with Log Analytics, I can have action groups, I can trigger actions to create and consume work items in an IT service management solution. ServiceNow has lots of instances in different countries, so now Tokyo has been added to those supported in preview. And then the Azure AD team has a number of materials for companies to help with the rollout, both for the help desk, for the end user. So they've added some new collateral to those. There's now a number of templates built around passwordless authentication. So you can go and look at these materials and download the ones you care about. So if we just scroll down and do details, you can see there's a whole bunch of things like posters, there are stickers, there are announcements, there are reminders, there's documents, there's messages. So you can just go and download the ones you care about. So you can scroll down and see all the different things. So maybe you have an MFA poster, for example. And they're just really nice materials that can help you in that communication, both with the end users and, of course, with the other people within the organization to help these things actually be a success. So they're free. You can go and download those. And as always, that was it. I hope it was useful. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video. Take care.